Pretty good crowd here today, Dick.
There is.
Yeah,
there
pretty,
is.
Pretty nice crowd for a Saturday afternoon football. All right. Number 22 for Nantucket, Alex Small, kicking off. Man, he gets a nice kick. Picked up by number 10, whom we don't know who he is. And he's hit by Norman Ramsey. And
Norman's
number 24 for Nantucket, I believe, is Kyle Frazee, sophomore.
5'11", 160-pound defensive back. Kyle doing some good special teams work here.
Special teams have been outstanding for Nantucket today. So we got first and 10. I think we're probably going to see an aerial attack. And quarterback throws it. Nice catch. Pitch and catch.
He says no.
No.
Yeah, I wasn't sure that he caught it.
Wow, pretty close.
Can hit the ground first.
He's trying to say he did. I don't know.
I'm going to let you see it right now.
It's not much.
They can run back.
It's not an argument that you want to worry about.
No.
How about Rex Ryan last week, Dennis, in the Patriots game, trying to argue for 7 yards on a 4th and 15 by throwing the red flag out? Now, what possibly are you going to gain? 4th and 15, 4th and 9, you know? Some battles you just don't want to give, but Rex likes to get into those battles that you shouldn't get involved in.
All right, up the middle, nice job by Nantucket's defense. Been stout all day.
Keenan's going to show us the play here. We got instant replay going.
I think he got it.
I think he got it, Gino. I think we should show that replay back to the officials here.
All right. Nantucket's defense has been very, very active today.
Yeah, working on their first potential shutout of the year here.
Yeah.
Shutting out Holbrook for the first half.
Good job, Owen West. 64 for Nantucket. Vinny Von Peterson. Van Peterson.
So, forcing the Holbrook punt, they have the wind. Let's see if he's back far enough.
Oh,
not a good kick
you,
at
Dick.
All.
Coming off. Oh, you
have to kick
there?
It in the window.
He tried to get it
over the fence here. He tried to get it over the fence, Gino. He couldn't quite get it over the fence. Did you show the people the fence down there?
Oh, yeah, that's right.
The new fence there, keeping the fans behind the fence.
What's the point of that?
They don't want any of those. They don't want any of those unruly fans getting to the press box of the team.
Maybe throwing up a play or two. All right, first and 10. The Whalers have very, very good field.
Excellent field position on that bad punt.
49-yard line. They're 49. And Demby goes in motion. And Jack had no place to go. Had nowhere to go. And
that's a sort of a misdirection type play there, where you're sending everybody right. You're trying to get the flow of the other team going right, and then you're trying to run it up
on that.
And they did admit, sometimes a smart defense will follow the flow. Sometimes just an average defense just stands there and waits for it to come to them, and that's what happened. Holgate came right to him.
All right, we got second down and going to go to Denby up the middle. Nice run by Denby.
Denby picks up about 8, so it's going to bring up 3rd and about 6 after the first down loss. Nantucket may be in 4-down territory here, too.
You think?
With the wind in their face, Dennis? We'll see.
I don't know.
We'll see.
Number 62 comes into the game for Avon Holbrook. And we got Holgate in I formation. And they're going to go pass. They're going to pass. And Holgate's going to run, and he's going to be hit way back, and there's a penalty flag right there.
They may refuse the penalty flag. Yeah, they may refuse the penalty flag. It's probably a holding, but they'll take the sack.
And they will take the sack. And that's the Klein. All right, another penalty. Puts the Whalers way back.
Now, you don't notice the penalty in that play, but if he completes that pass for a big gainer, then the penalty would have been kind of huge.
That would have really stung, yeah. All right, so, we're going to punt it.
First punt into the wind here today for the Whalers.
And it takes a bounce. Get Brony with the punt, and it gets the wind.
Only a 12-yarder there with the wind. So there's the problem about going into the wind. So now if they had fourth and two or three, do you think they would have went for it?
Possibly, yeah. Possibly. I guess you would.
Now, they haven't kicked that much into the wind or not into the wind today, but you get yourself in, a dogfight type game, and then you have a real massive decision, because if you realize that you're only getting 10 or 12 yards a punt.
I think I would probably kick into the wind, because anything can happen. The ball can hit, come down.
Oh, yeah. You get the turnover, right. But what I'm saying is, if you're in a critical situation and you've punted three or four times today and you're only averaging 10 or 12 yards a punt, that makes a coach think a little bit about what he wants to do.
Oh, fumble. Shortest pass in football. And let's see.
Nantucket saying they got it.
And they did. And number 75 for Nantucket.
Nick Correa.
Big fumble recovery.
Now, Nick was upset on that penalty call there, which is, I'm assuming, the penalty was probably called on him. So he makes quick redemption here and gets the fumble back.
All right.
We have a timeout here on the field. I'd like to mention some of our fine sponsors during this timeout. Jim Hollis Restoration, Island Variety, Island Carpets, Connell Electric, James Lydon Roofing, Espresso to Go, Rennell's Garage, the NRTA, Randy Alford Plumbing and Heating, Scrub Oak, Scrimshaw Gallery, Flyboard Nantucket, Eastwood Trading Company, Glidden's Island Seafood, Geronimo's, Cottage and Castle, Joe Rapacki, Killen Real Estate, Cam Appliance, Rick's Paint and Maintenance, Nantucket Seafood, Nantucket Booster Club, Nantucket Health Club, Fazzaro's Homemade Italian, Varian Masonry, Axe Screen and Window Repair, Shepherd Real Estate, Nantucket Airlines, and the Steamship Authority, the new guy aboard. If you'd like to be the new guy aboard and advertise for 6 months for just $500, here's what you get. Sponsorship of the Whaler Sports TV. Have your ad read right here by us during the live broadcast for all 6 months. A graphic ad, your logo and phone number, playing 24/7 on our local zone for 6 months, and a 15-second ad. That includes production and broadcasting, 1 month on TV, plus 4 months as a pre-roll on GinoTV.com. You get all this for just $20 per week. Give Gino a call at 592-508-292-2203 or check him out on Gino@GinoTV.com.
All right, first and 10. And number 31, Young, scored the first touchdown for Nantucket. He gets about three or four yards.
Yeah, did he go out banged up after that touchdown?
He went out banged up.
Yeah, but he's back now.
He was just carrying the ball up and down the sideline here. All right, we got second down and about six. He got a better game than I thought.
Yes.
All right. Second and six.
I just read those, Jim.
And there's a movement. There's movement.
Yeah.
It's gonna come back. It's gonna come back. Another penalty. Legal procedure. And that does hurt.
This one does hurt because he had made the first down. So now it's going to come back and make it second and about 11 rather than first and 10, a difference of about 12 yards, or actually more than 12 yards, about 14 yards. So it works out to be like a 14-yard penalty.
And they bring him off. All right, so it's second 11.
So we heard a total of 90 yards penalized today.
Already?
That's a lot.
At the half?
Well, as of right now.
As of right now.
As of right now, they've been penalized 90 yards.
And Gabroni in motion, and a nice hole there for Holgate. And he scoots up and gets up maybe a 7 or 8, 9 yard gain.
I think it's going to be close to 11, Dennis. I think he might be close to making it.
Yeah, you're right. He's about, a yard short.
Third and about less than a yard.
Okay. Could be a nice down to throw on, Dick.
Yeah.
Go for the bomb. Well, let's see now. And up the middle. No.
Oh, we get stopped in the backfield.
Put down. What do you do?
Got to go for it.
Demby is stopped short. And they lose us about a yard.
You're talking about throwing on that down there. That was the ideal formation to throw it out of, too.
Absolutely.
Because everybody's thinking run, and all you have to do is you have you one receiver just sort of delay at the line of scrimmage and go for it.
Go deep, go low. All right, big fourth down for the Nantucket Whalers.
He actually lost a yard on that, so now it is fourth and a long one.
All right.
Broken play, but
it's got the outside. Look at the blocking.
It's coming back.
Block in the back.
Coming back.
And
that's the second one coming back today.
This one hurts.
Yes.
Coming back.
So it's going to make it fourth.
We got a hold.
It's going to be fourth and long.
Fourth and
so now they are over 100 yards.
Wow. This is the second game in a row that Wales have had a tremendous number of penalties.
Fourth and eight.
Now I think that would probably change the philosophy.
They might.
They sent a punter in.
A punter in?
Yeah, punt formation, punt teams in. And I think that's the move. And the snap is good. Good. And
that hit a Nantucket player.
Yeah. Okay. It was close to hitting an Avon Holbrook.
Shouldn't that be
from the spot?
That should be Avon's ball right from where it hit the Nantucket guy.
That's from the spot.
Yeah, he brings it back there. Okay, it hit the Nantucket kid in the head. But as you're saying, if it hit the Holbrook kid in the head,
now if it bounced around, it bounced off a Nantucket player and hit a Holbrook player.
Do you remember this game from back in the 80s? Remember David Hunter?
Yeah.
Twice in the same game, in a game like this, the punt hit him in the helmet.
Yeah.
And once it was turned over and once it wasn't.
Was that the day when we had the big rainstorm?
Yeah, poor David.
I remember that day very well.
Blue Hills, raining like crazy. David was the defensive captain, calling plays, with wearing glasses.
He was here.
Here on Nantucket.
And that was the beginning of the no-name storm.
Right. And we were on the other side of the field though, in those days.
In those days, yeah.
The new era on this side of the field.
You have to adapt, Dick, in this life.
But twice in this, I never thought I'd see that. Twice in the same game, the ball came down and hit him in the head. Poor David couldn't see a thing. Rain pouring into his glasses.
That's all David's listening to that.
As we bring back.
Bring back memories. He's going to throw it. He's going to run it. He runs out of bounds.
Norman Ramsey and JT over there pushing him out of bounds. Quarterback smart, though. He avoids the hit and gets out of bounds before the hit comes.
And we'll see where they spot it.
They didn't give him much of a gain, though.
He's got a third down. And what?
Eight.
Yeah. Pretty hard pickup here for Avon.
Yeah. Again, though, I think the quarterback's got to roll out and get around Ramsey. Although he has success rolling to the left away from Ramsey. Here comes Ramsey again. This time they pick him up.
And it's incomplete. Nice throw, though.
Dylan Ray come over. If Dylan Ray doesn't get over there, Dennis, it's probably caught by 45. But Dylan gets here and almost makes a acrobatic catch to pull it in himself.
2:51 left in the period, Dick. Is that?
Third quarter, yeah.
2:50.
Clock has stopped after the incomplete pass.
And
nice punt this time.
Denby has it. And they got the wall set up. He has the wall. And he's going to cut it back. Inside the 20, he's pushed out of bounds.
Denby is one of the better punt returners we've seen.
You see the nice job they have with the wall? Good job by the Nantucket special teams coach.
Special team sets up a nice wall.
Beautiful wall.
And Denby, in this short season so far, is showing me to be one of the better punt return guys in the game here. He gets up there. He gets behind his wall. He looks for a seam, and when he finds it, he breaks it. This time, there's no big seam, but he still brings it back like 40 yards.
And they're going to go outside. He cuts it in. It gets down to, he's still on his feet.
So he's going to pick up about 8 or 9 yards in
that. Kept his feet going.
On a play that didn't look like it was going anywhere.
He was stopped, but he kept his feet going.
Now they're going to say six, so it's going to be second and four. The ball's on about the 9. They can get a first down inside the 5.
Okay, here we go. We got motion and up the middle. Ball goes to number 22. Alex Small.
He might not have picked it up.
Quickly.
He might not have picked it up.
He did not. They get a first down at the 3? Is there another flag on the field over there?
There is a flag over there, Dennis. Yeah, I just saw it myself. Let's see what this one is. This may go against Holbrook, yeah.
It's half the distance.
I think the kid jumped offside. Even if it is a 5 yard, it's half the distance, right, because inside the 10.
And let's see where they spot it now. It might be a first down.
So now it's... Now it's first and goal as they drop the flags over there.
Yeah. All right, they're tucking some good spot here. And Denby's going to cut. Oh, he's going to reverse the field. And he's going to roll into the end zone.
He gets in.
Touchdown.
Yeah. Denby, his second of the day on a 4 yard run. And, Nantucket has opened it up to a 20-0 with the extra point coming up. This extra point brought to us by Albert G. Brock Insurance wants to wish each and every student the best year. Brock Insurance is here to provide you with all your insurance needs.
Okay, Akeem Henry on the kick. Yeah, we got timeout.
Timeout on the field. The extra point brought to us by Nantucket Island Pharmacies. We covered in town and out of town. In town, 45 Main Street. Out of town, 122 Pleasant Street. Prescriptions, nutrition, beauty products, cards, health aids, Nantucket Island Pharmacies.
Okay, here we go. It's going to be a kick. Oh, wait a minute. Young man's being taken off.
He has a bad leg there.
So he's the second big lineman that's out of the game.
The other lineman is over there on the bench.
Again, attrition. And makes it good.
So 3 for 3 for Akeem. So Nantucket now has scored in each and every period. 7-0 after the first period, 14-0 at halftime, and 21-0 now with 1:22 to go in the period. Smile, Dennis. You're going to be on candid camera here.
All right, Dick. 21-0. Nantucket in control.
In control. Going to go to 3-0. You know, they're setting up very similar to last year when they ran through the Mayflower Small 7-0. Next week coming up is the Sacred Heart, the new guy in the block.
We'll have to see how they do against West Bridgewater. If it's a close game, it could be a tough game here next week.
Yeah, I'm thinking that when Nantucket and West Bridgewater meet, both teams might be 5-0. So that might be the one.
If I was playing Nantucket, I would look for that. When Denby gets the ball, I would always look for the cutback. Make sure the kid stays home.
Well, that's the hardest thing about defending Nantucket, because Holgate does the same thing.
Yeah.
When he gets a chance to run the ball.
And on his feet, looks like Shane O'Connor again, number one. And 15 for Nantucket. We don't have his number. Number 15 was in on the tackle.
There's a 14 here, Padilla.
Maybe. Well, yeah.
That'll be our guess. I'm looking down at the field for a 14. I don't see a 14.
Yeah, there's a 14 down there.
Oh, there is a 14. Yeah. So it's not him then.
No. There's a 15.
15, well, not
maybe
on
our, good job.
Not on our roster.
Yeah, maybe.
Wait a minute. Let's look on the back side, the JV roster side then. There we go.
Number 15.
Is an eighth grader?
Jarrett O'Connor?
I don't know.
I don't know.
It's a JV rod. I don't know if there's any JVs dressed or not today.
No, I don't think so.
One 12 to go here. Timeout on the field.
Getting a little chilly up here, Dick. Want to give me a jacket?
It is getting chilly. Dennis, you would have to have ice coming off your nostrils to get this jacket off me.
It's a try.
It's a try. It almost worked. During this timeout, as Dennis looks for a jacket, I would like to mention some of our fine sponsors. The UPS Store, Don Allen Auto Center, Census Rubbish Removal, Outdoor Power, Stover Engineering, Pete's Fresh Fish Prints, Valero & Sons, Fast Forward, Fairgrounds Restaurant, The Sea Grill, The Island of Packet Store, Barco's Eat Tacos, Harbor Fuel Oil Corporation, Arrowhead Nursery, The Beauty Bar, Woolen Wash Gallery, Magic Touch Cleaning Service, Island Variety, Island Pharmacy, Congdon Coleman Insurance, Island Fencing, Nantucket Boys and Girls Club, Hawthorne House, Rider Electric, Kitty Murtaugh's Just Do It 2, The Dog Wash, Gray Lady Insurance, Champion Rentals, TNT Lawn Sprinkling, Supply New England, Sister Salon Spa, Lindsay Incorporated, Albert G. Brock, Island Lumber, Martin Bork Painting, Sherbet Management, Humphrey Electric, and the Downey Flank. We thank all these fine sponsors for bringing you Wheel of Sports on TV.
All right, we've got a minute 12 left. The ball's on the about the 18-yard line. First and 10. And what have we got? Look at Dick. Look at this. We got a spread formation. Look at this. Wow.
And then
Nantucket should have taken a timeout, though.
Well, Holbrook takes a timeout because they seem to be...
They confused themselves.
They're more confused
themselves.
Of course,
number 34 over there, he's staying. He's coming in. Oh, I don't know. This is very confusing.
Well, at least Holbrook is adding a little excitement to a game with a trailing 21-0.
All right, we got a spread formation. And all it needs is seven men on the line of scrimmage or more. You can put them any way you want. And they're going to be hit. And that goes for nothing. Number 24 on the tackle for Nantucket, Kyle Frazee. Good job. Smelled it out. And we got a second down and 10.
The Nantucket defense is fired up there. They're asking the fans to get into it and do some yelling. I think the fans are stunned over there that their team has left them and come to this side of the field.
Yeah, I know. They're not. We got to take a poll. Are you happy or unhappy?
They need to be a little louder so that they can hear them over
there. They can't hear them on this side,
right? Right. They got to scream it out.
And he throws it deep.
Oh.
And the end stopped. Number 34 stopped in his route. One thing, the receiver, you never, ever stop. The quarterback's responsibility, throw the ball. And you run as fast as you can to get open.
Let's talk about the Island Cup game if this same format's in. The Vineyard on that side of the field.
Oh, wow.
There's going to be a lot of Vineyard fans over there, right?
So they're going to be dominating the stands.
There'll be Vineyard fans and Nantucket fans on that side of the field. That's going to be exciting.
Oh, wow.
But we have another exciting play coming up here, Dennis, with this
new formation.
Spread formation.
It's a third down and 10. The quarterback throws the ball really well, though.
That's got a sack. That's a sack.
Was anybody around? No. Penalty.
They're just going to call it a sack.
I think it's a loss of down, too. Yeah.
Goes in the books as a sack.
Intentional grounding. Yeah, that's a great point, Dick.
Yeah.
What about...
Yeah, the stands are going to be shaking that day. Because
there's going to be nobody over here.
Vineyard brings a lot of... it's hard to be over here now because
our fans will be sitting there a little...
You got to get over this 8-foot fence here. It's hard to get over that 8-foot fence to walk along the sidelines.
Oh, Dick, we're going to be in trouble.
What else is new?
All right. You got the fourth down. How's the third down?
We're not sure what the down is yet.
I think it's a loss of down. Intentional grounding. I think it's a loss of fourth down.
Looks like Nantucket's declining the penalty, so it's going to bring up fourth down, right?
All right, so they're going to have to punt with the wind. And 17.2 seconds left. So Nantucket, wow.
This kid's having a horrible day punting. That's going to go as like a 6-yard punt with the wind behind him. But the punter sort of turned his whole body sideways.
He looked right at us.
Yeah.
He wanted to be on television.
Well, I think he got to credit the Nantucket defense because they had some pressure coming up the middle. So I think he was sort of turning away from the pressure.
Well, I think they got a good spot, don't
they? They got an excellent spot, yeah. Yeah, the Nantucket... staff is talking to the officials, but the officials are saying, you got a 21-0 lead. Let's not worry about 10 yards here.
Yeah. All right. First and 10. All right. Colgate up the middle. Calls his own number. And we got somebody. All right. He gets up. Third quarter comes to an end. Nantucket, 21. Holbrook, Avon, nothing.
One thing that we haven't talked about that much, Dennis, this year is the Red Sox.
They're great. I love them.
I'm gonna go over the new guys here. You tell me whether these new guys are going to be back. When the Red Sox spend $260 million on these guys here, you tell me whether they're going to be back next year or whether they got their money's worth.
Shoot.
Wade Miley.
We'll be back.
Did they get their money's worth?
Yes.
Ryan Hennigan.
Yes.
They got their money's worth. He'll be back. Justin Matheson didn't get their money. He's already gone.
No.
Panda ball.
No.
Rick Pacello.
I think it could be. Yeah. Yes.
Hanley Ramirez. No. So, how much do you think these six guys are worth out of the $360 million?
Probably more than half.
More than half. But right now, you said you're excited with the Sox.
Yes.
Right now, they're playing some pretty good baseball.
Absolutely.
Did you see that play last night?
Yeah,
where both of them scored on the same play?
Ball guys can really motor.
I thought Jerry Remy was going to come out of his seat.
That would be like you and I were on the bases. You'd be ahead of me and I'd be right behind you.
No. My next question is, did anyone ever catch you from behind?
No way, baby.
All right, we're in the boy here.
Yeah, that's going to be a good run.
He goes up the middle, second and six. He picked up about three, so he's going to bring up third and about four. Gino's having some fun here.
Yeah, going live.
The live is really great, isn't it?
Gino.
Love it.
Gino brought in Jim to run the camera here. Gino's having a lot of fun wandering around behind us here today.
Well, I saw your ad on TV, Gino.
Which one?
The one up, you could be seen in China.
Oh, yeah.
Dick and I are going to.
Yeah, you're on,
We're on in China, Dick.
We're on in China. How do you call fourth to one in China?
You're going to offend some people in China. That was my interpretation
of fourth and one. I'll do it again. That's fourth and one in China.
Oh, God.
They picked up a first down while I was talking, see?
All right. And the flag.
Holding, bring it back. Bring it back.
Oh, my goodness. That's the third touchdown.
Third touchdown of the day called back.
Yep. The penalty is a huge issue for the Whales today.
Well, that must bring it up to about 125 yards in penalties against the Whales. But the big stat is that three touchdowns called back, right?
Lock and ball on the waist.
I get a feeling that Holbrook isn't a very big school.
No, it's not, actually.
Yeah. I mean, they have a lot of guys on the team.
I mean, no, they play.
Comparatively.
They have a good basketball program, uh-huh. Traditionally, and Avon has a good basketball program. But it's just that football's not big there.
It's a real blue-collar town, though, yeah. And probably they probably had some families moving out of town, but they'll probably have a lot of kids that are going to school of choice now. You got school of choice. They can go over to BC High. They can go to Catholic Memorial. Things like that. So they probably lose a lot of kids that way.
And up the middle, first man through.
Look at this.
A good run.
Wow, only
Alex Small, right up the middle.
Yeah, he gets back all the yards. Is lost on a penalty. About a 15-yard pickup.
Nice run.
Going to bring up about third and eight. I still had Mark second. I thought it was third. All right. They replayed the down. All right, so it is second.
All right. And up the middle again, Alex Small. And he gets the ball up to about the 16-yard line.
Giving Small a lot of work here.
Yeah.
Third
and maybe six.
Third and six, right? You know, pick up the six, Dennis. It might be a good spot to practice your field goal. You don't need the three-point.
Akeem Henry has not missed yet.
Well, he missed one last week.
Did he really?
Remember, sure? Remember the one he missed last week? No?
I
could be wrong. I'm not going to go out on a limb on that one, no.
D- Dick, you're out of the limbo.
But it wasn't it
anyway?
He had to miss one. Wasn't it 27-8 last week?
Yes. All right, there's going to be a pitch. And Denby goes in again for the hat trick.
In from the 17 for Denby.
And there's another penalty flag.
Now, is that going to bring the back, or is that Nantucket's clapping this time? So maybe it's a hit in the end zone.
Maybe it's a personal foul.
Maybe it's a late hit in the end zone. Let's see.
Let's see what it is. Dead ball foul. Must be some. Somebody said something. Let's see.
So that could be 15 on the kickoff. So they'll kick the extra point, and then they'll pick up 15 yards on the kickoff.
You don't like to see that.
No.
All right. Keem Henry. And he's a left foot kicker, and he's got it, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, that was good.
Got it. Four for four. So Nantucket has scored one touchdown in every quarter. And what you don't like to see is that the kid that got taken out of the game is over there taking off his shoulder pads. That's not what you want to see.
No.
Not what you want to see. No. I know the kid's upset, but no reason for him to go over and take his shoulder pads off and sit there like
that.
No,
keep your uniform on.
I don't believe he's been kicked out of the game.
Well, maybe.
Who is it?
34, I believe, yeah.
So the wheel is going to 3-0, and last week winning 27-8. Today they're already up 28-0. The ball's moved up here to the 45. So this will definitely be kicked through the end zone here. As Nantucket's going to have the easy kick with
it. I would squib it,
you squib it too.
Yeah,
but you're sort of rubbing it in, because the only reason why you'd squib it would be to get the ball back quicker, you know. It's not the thing the other team would like to see you have do against them in this situation. You get them down enough.
Yeah, he's going to kick it through the end zone.
So that's
a break for.
Yeah, you take advantage. Yeah, you take advantage of your 15 yards that you picked up. You kick the ball through the end zone, and you give Avon the ball in the 20, and then you let your defense take the ball back from, rather than getting it back. If you're in a close game, if you're in a game where you need the ball in a hurry, naturally it would be a great spot to try the squib kick or the onside kick to get it back quicker.
I got a question for you, Dick. Is the width of the field the same in the pros as it is here?
Yes.
Okay, so it's exactly the same.
56 yards.
Okay. How much?
56. Cross.
Is it 53 and a third?
I think it's 56.
You think it's 56. Look it up, Gino.
Look it up on the
56
internet.
Or 50. I'm going to go with 53 and a third.
I'm going to go with 56.
All right, okay. Gino's going to look it up, the width of the field. But it is the same, yes. It is the same.
So same. 53 foot 4 inches versus 56.
For some reason, that number sticks in my head. Gino's going to verify.
No, he's the expert on numbers.
We know it's 100 yards long.
53 and a third.
Oh, no. No.
No, it says high school overall football field dimensions.
That's why he gets car service.
Oh, okay. My goodness.
Yeah, it is. NFL, same
Dennis,
thing.
Dennis, don't mess with the math. You got to buy a drink tonight,
that's
Dennis. You got to buy me a drink tonight, Dennis. If I pulled that number out of my head.
53 and a third.
53 and a third. Dennis will never forget that now for the rest of his life.
I'm having a bad day yesterday. There's no doubt about it. All right, here we go.
Even that little third thrown in, it was. If I said 53, you'd probably
be. Well, you should have said 53.333.
53.3 with the bar over it, repeat.
Wow.
All right, rolling out.
It was a good throw and a good run. Oh, nice job by number 16 for Nantucket, is that? Hakeem Henry.
Was he in on the defense?
Yeah.
Getting a little defense?
Getting a little action.
I see a lot of new numbers in there, Dennis.
I think that they want to get as many
guys
in.
We'll call some of them out as we see them. 50's in there.
Well, 50's been in there the whole time.
We don't have him. 24's in there. Kyle
11's in there. Bodie Sargent.
I like Sergeant Bowie better. Let's go to Sarge. The Sarge is in there.
And up the middle. And Norman Ramsey,
he's been in a lot of tackles.
Yeah.
Garcia, sophomore.
Number 24, Kyle Frazee. We helped make that tackle.
So there's a combination of new guys in there with some of the regular guys.
Some of the veterans.
Let the young guys play a little bit.
Absolutely. He's substituting a few of the younger guys, right?
That's important. They practice too.
You bet.
And they're going to pitch it out. And
West was the first one there. Garcia in on his second tackle.
The clock is running. 6:11 left in the game. Okay, we got third down.
Third down coming up here.
About four.
Portion of this game brought to us by the Steamship Authority, Don Allen Auto Center, Harbor Fuel Oil Corporation, SeaGrow Restaurant.
And the first man through gets the ball. And pretty close to the first down.
Yeah, he breaks it to the outside. One of the first times he tried to turn the corner on a play like that and doesn't quite make it there.
No, I think he's got it.
They gave it to him, though.
First and 10. Avon Holbrook had a tough day. They had to travel all the way out. It's a pretty long ride, actually.
They
left Boston.
First down, Holbrook.
I would say early in the morning.
I would say 7:30, 8 o'clock, right? Because they probably came on that 9 o'clock steamship fast.
And they're going to throw it nice and easy, incomplete. He tried to feather the ball in there rather than throw it.
Yeah, a little bit of a lead on him. He should have just taken the 4 or 5 yards and be satisfied. He's trying to hit him in stride to get him running up the field.
Quarterback shows a lot of talent. I don't know what year he is, but he has some talent. There's no doubt about it.
I don't know what year any of them are.
I know.
I don't know any of their names.
High school football, Dick.
Me and Chris Worth did a game once, and
you don't know either side.
We made up names and we used pro names, right? Let me show you something. We had people like Tarkenton at quarterback and stuff like that. I didn't want to get into that today. We just call them the no names.
He got outside, hit by number 45. Owen West.
Yeah, it's tough.
Owen caught a big pass last week. Remember that?
It's tough for them to turn the corner on Owen. Owen really shuts that corner down.
So we got a third down and about nine.
If there's a long play, like a kick or a pass.
Under 5 minutes left.
And it's easy enough to follow because you can see.
And they might just go for it here in fourth down, too.
Yeah, no doubt. And second man through. We're going to get outside. And stop. I keep thinking of the Nantucket sideline, but.
It's going to bring up fourth and about four.
Number one, Shane O'Connor in there. Number 68, I believe. Inferni Garcia.
Garcia, yeah. He's...
The other thing I do is I don't make any fast
JT is back, still back in safety.
Yeah, they want to sort of protect their shutout.
They do.
They'll give them a little, but they don't want to give them the bomb.
Yeah.
But they need four here.
Oh! What a tackle by Norman Ramsey.
That's his third sack of the day. And
number 50.
Coach Ryder is calling his team over. This is where you try to probably put in a second offense if you have it. No, I guess not.
Yeah.
No, I see the regular numbers going back out there.
So 77, Will Smalls going in there.
A few subs, but mainly the starters. Holgate going out.
Now this is a nice time when everybody gets a chance to play.
This should be a pretty vanilla offense here for the last 3:24.
And Jack Holgate still a signal caller. And up the middle.
Now you're going to go in with a couple subs on each play.
Number 12, we don't have his number.
Will Small going in. 12 could be Jason Adams.
Could be.
Listed on the JV roster. We'll go with that.
Corey Ryder's out of the game.
We're going to give a wrap up in our three stars here as we narrow down. Clock is running and Nantucket won't be throwing the ball here, so it should keep on running.
Nice run by Young. Scored the first touchdown for Nantucket.
Right.
Number 78, Nick Gully going into the game.
First down, Nantucket.
56 comes out, and that's Jared Funderburg. Number 12, we don't know who he is.
Well, if you want to go with the JV guy in the back.
Yeah.
Wrap up on the day, Keyshawn Young scored the opening period, fifth play of the game on an 18-yard run. Akeem Henry kicked the extra point as he did after all four touchdowns. We'll give the rest of that after this play.
So Nantucket sits upon the small division. I saw it in the Herald on Friday.
Young spins ahead there almost for the first time. So after Keyshawn Young scored in the first period, it became the Travis Denby show. Travis scored on a 53-yarder in the second period. That made it 14-0 at halftime. He scored a 4-yarder in the third period. That made it 21-0 after three periods. And then he finished off with a 17-yarder here in the fourth quarter.
Injury timeout on the field.
Injury timeout.
Should we do our...
As Dr. Lepre's out there.
Want to do our three stars?
Okay.
I went first last week, so you can go first.
All right. I am going to go... My number three star is going to go to Owen West. Mainly for doing a sophomore, but for his outside linebacker. Keeping him honest. My number two star is going to go to the hat trick guy, Travis Denby, who scored three touchdowns today. And my number one star is going to go to Norman Ramsey. He had many tackles, three of them sacks, a couple more for losses. So those are my three, Dennis.
Okay, my number three star goes to Travis Denby, the hat trick guy. He ran the ball pretty well. Played a good game on defense also.
Defense also. Made some
nice tackles. My number two guy is going to Nick Correa. Anchored the defensive line today. Very, very solid. In and a lot of tackles. And my number one guy, I'm going to agree with you, Norman Ramsey. Had an outstanding day on defense.
Storming Norman.
Yes, he did.
Comes up with a double number one star. Good game, Norman. A good game all the wheelers today.
Yep. So, clock is rolling, 1:30. And number 33 going to get a carry. 33 for Nantucket is, we must be a JV.
Ben Rippard. Rippard, is that how you say it?
Ben Rippard, 11th grader. Number 33. Number 14's in there, we don't know. 14 is Kevin Padilla.
So there. Can we see Nick Currier move over to center here?
Oh, yeah. There are teams. And, oh, Young is going to go around right away. Good job by, is that the quarterback, number 14?
44. And that could be the final play of the day here. And Nantucket will go back in the huddle.
34-30.
It'll be fourth down.
They may have to snap it one more time.
And looking over Travis Lombardi, he says if he has to snap it, just put his knee down. Either way, Holbrook might get one more play. I don't think the officials will push it. I don't think they'll give him a... I think they'll let him stay in the huddle. They could give him a penalty here and give Holbrook one more play, but they're not going to. They're going to just let it run down.
So Nantucket moves to 3-0 on the season. Starting to be a very exciting season, Dick.
And a very exciting team. And the one big thing that I look at that we haven't talked about today is nobody get banged up on the Nantucket side.
No, not at all.
We saw Young come out earlier in the game, but he went right back in there afterwards. But and
for me, the biggest asset is their skill people, and they seem to have a lot of good linemen. I think the blocking was pretty good today. The biggest deficit is their penchant for getting penalties.
Yeah,
that's what's really going to hurt them as they go on this season, I think.
I think Otto Fisher is like 140 yards against them. So.
Yeah, I mean, that's something that needs to be addressed.
Yeah. All right, so we congratulate the Whales. We'll be back here this Friday night as the new team, Sacred Heart, comes in. And it's a new team, but it's a Catholic school team. We've seen how a Catholic school team can get fired up and get good athletes in there.
Absolutely.
We've seen that with
St. Pope John Paul.
St. Pope John Paul. So we'll be excited about Sacred Heart coming in here. And looking forward to it. We'll see you here Saturday night. We'll be here live streaming on Geno TV. We'll also be at the... girls soccer game this Thursday afternoon. Look for 4 o'clock start on that. So we thank Jim Hollis for jumping in, doing some camera work today. Geno game on production. Dennis Caron calling today's game. This is Dick Herman saying good night. Visit a network TV, Geno TV 99. And remember to put a smile on your face each and every day, Dennis, even if you laugh at yourself. Go Patriots and go Bears. The 0-2 Bears against
thanks,
the 0-2
Dick.
Seattle. Go Bears.
Go.
The Bears. Go.